Hello and welcome back. Today we're going to build an Arduino robotic arm with 5 servo motors and joystick control. And whether you're a beginner, or you're doing this as a classroom project or a group project, or you're just a hobbyist, hopefully this video can be a resource for you as you build your own. So let's begin with telling you what you need to start out.
Here's everything that I used for this project. I'm using a Arduino Uno. You can use Mega if you want, or whichever one you prefer. I'm using a joystick. I'm also using 2 buttons. That's what I'm using to switch between the servos. You're going to need some male-to-male jumper wires for your connection to the servos, and then male-to-female jumper wires for your connection to the joystick. I'm also using 5 servos, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm using some brackets too, which you can see right here. I bought 2 sets of these, and I'll link them in the description. They are pretty handy. I bought 2 sets of servos, which are these guys right here. They are the MG995 servos. You can buy a higher torque servo, but these are fast servos. They do fine. And I also bought this claw, this gripper here. And we'll talk about that in just a minute. Now the base of this is just craft board. It's not a good idea, but I had it, so I wanted to use it. And in the bottom of it, I use a screw and a nut to hold it together. The bracket on this servo right here is going to be sitting like this. And I just ran that M3 screw through the base plate there and then put a nut on the other side, and that's what you see there. And those are the M3 screw and nut here. These are actually pretty good. If you've ever bought these, sometimes they don't thread them very well, but these are really good. I haven't had any problems with them. And I put this in the description too. It's on Amazon if you're interested in getting these. So I use that to bolt it down here and attach it, and then I taped it down. I'll make a real base in the next video. And then down here for my joystick, I use that same craft board. And you've seen this in other videos. I just put a couple spots of hot glue to hold down the joystick. So nothing fancy. Now for the power supply, you want an external power supply for these servos. I used a 5-volt, 2-amp power supply here. And just because it's good, stable power supply. And then I used this over here and attached it to the rails on my breadboard. Do not run that through your Arduino. That will destroy it. Or you can use an external power supply. You can use a benchtop power supply too. That'll be just as good. So that is it when it comes to everything that I used to put this together. Next, we'll talk about assembling the arm itself. Putting the arm itself together was pretty easy. I bought 2 sets of these brackets. This is 1 set. The other set is here that you see on the arm. I like these because there's a lot of options to connect your servos all together. And then you've got these big brackets here, which you can connect together as well, which I did right here in the middle. And I like them because you can use the M3 screw and nut, which I've done right here. That holds very nice. And then you also have it comes with the plates. The servos come with the plates that you can put on the rotating shaft here. And then the black screws hold really well as well for that. And again, I'm using the MG995. It's a high speed servo motor. You can get higher torque, which probably would be better for an arm. But for me, this is multi-purpose, so it works out pretty well. Now the gripper that I'm using, I have kind of a mixed opinion about that. We'll start with the instructions. The instructions are pretty horrible. This is called the Metal Claw G6. So they give you a list of stuff that you get. But I mean, look at the pictures. You can't tell what that stuff is. So I didn't know. And then the next sheet, it's not any better. It's really hard to determine, you know, where screws and bolts and all that stuff go. So I had an idea of how to put it together, and I just looked at the pictures online, and I just wing it, basically. But I did it, and it didn't take too long.
This claw is mounted on a servo and can rotate 180 degrees to orient itself to any object you may want to pick up. The servo motor that came with the claw is a digital high-torque MG996R servo motor, which gives it a very smooth motion, as you can see here. One thing I like about this claw is that it has a wide range of motion, allowing you to pick up larger objects. I also like that extra wide claw that the gripper has on both sides, adding a little bit of extra stability to whatever it's picking up. You'll know some of the grippers have a real narrow grip, and not this one. This one helps you pick up those larger objects with that wide grip. The material itself is an aluminum alloy, which makes it a little difficult to pick up smooth objects. Those smooth objects, you have to grip them just right, or they'll squirt right out of the claw and get away from you. Now, those objects that are tacky and rough, like this little ball right here, these are perfect to be picked up by the claw. It does a really good job. Now, over time, the parts that actually grab the object may slowly become loose. And that may be on me. I don't want to over-tighten the parts and damage the metal. So to me, it's just a minor thing to have to re-tighten these parts every once in a while. But it is something you should be aware of.
Now, let me show you the connections for this project. On the joystick, we have a 5-volt and a ground. And those are connected directly to the Arduino. Now we also have an X and a Y axis, and those are connected to pins A0 and A1, our analog pins. Over here we have two buttons, and those are connected to the ground rail right here on the breadboard, and then the buttons are connected to pins 7 and 8 on the Arduino. Now for the servo motors, each servo motor has three connections, three pins. It has a data pin, and over here you see the data pins of the servos connected to 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So this bottom servo here is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now the other two pins on the servo is a 5-volt pin and a ground pin, and they are all connected to an external power supply of 5 volts right here. And they're connected to our 5-volt rail and the ground rail. Do not connect those to your Arduino.
Well, here's my code for the Arduino robotic arm, and I got about halfway through the video explaining what each part of the code does, but I decided not to put that in the video because usually viewership has a big dip around sections like that, and that affects the watch time and the algorithm and how the video is distributed. So this is just something I'm trying out. I will be posting it to the Facebook page, as always, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment section or contact me by email or ask on Facebook or Twitter, and I'll be happy to answer any questions that you might have. Let's go ahead and pick up this ball here for a short demo. Now, some of you may be wondering why I chose to use two buttons and a joystick to operate this arm, and that's convenient for me. That's all I have is one joystick. I'd like to buy another joystick and actually build a controller to use on multiple projects, but this was convenient for me, and it can be tricky at times, cycling between these servo motors, but that's what you do when you're working with Arduino. You adapt to what you have, right? So that's what I did. I plan on doing more videos with this Arduino arm, just to see what all we can do with it, so I hope you check those videos out as well.
Well, that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you're interested in the code, we post it to our Facebook page. Check the description below for details, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you again very soon.